Okay, so now we have a question class, but we can't really do much with it because it has a question, but it doesn't have any way to answer it. And the way you answer the question is going to depend on the type of question it is. So if it's a multiple choice question, you're going to select which option you want. If it's multiple select, you're going to select a set of options. If it's a type-in question, you're going to type in the answer and so on. So these things that we have now are common to all questions, but the part we're going to do next are only for specific types of questions. And the way you represent that in JavaScript is by having multiple classes where one class inherits from another class. So I'm going to go ahead and let's start with this income question here. So income, what is your yearly income? Please include income from all sources. And then there's a bunch of options, and you're going to select one of these mutually exclusive options. And so this is going to be a multiple choice question. So we're going to create a new constructor for a new class called multiple choice question. And it's going to have a title and a text, just like a regular question. And it's also going to have a set of options. And I'm just going to have an array of values there, one for each option. And then what I'm going to do is this is going to be the parent class, or sometimes called the super class, and this is going to be the child class, or sometimes called the subclass. And so I want multiple choice question to inherit everything that's defined for questions, all the stuff with the title and the text and two HTML. And there's a couple of different ways of doing that in JavaScript, and there's some trade-offs. But for this class, I'm going to pick the simplest possible one. Not the most efficient one, but the simplest one, because I think the concepts are the important part this time around. We'll look at the inheritance model in more detail in 233W. But what I'm going to do is basically for each new multiple choice question I create, the first thing I'm going to do is call the constructor for question on that object. So everything that's defined in the constructor for a question object will also be defined for a multiple choice question object. And then after I've done that, then I'm going to define the stuff that's specific for multiple choice question. Now, the way you call this constructor on an object, when you have an object and you want to run a method, it's usually this dot method name arguments. But this is not going to work here because there is no method called question. Right? This is just an empty object right now. I haven't done anything to it. So there's no constructor, there's no question method on this object. So what I need is a way of calling question, the question constructor, as if it were a method, even though it's not really on this object. And there's a special function that you can use to do that. So question is a function, and functions are objects in JavaScript, and objects have methods. And one of the methods on the question object is called call. So to get this effect, I can do this. Question.call, and then the first argument is going to be the object I want to call it on. So this means exactly the same thing as this dot question of title and text would mean, except this works and the other doesn't. So let's go ahead and test that so far. So I'm going to save this, and I'm going to go back to my console, and I'm going to create, actually have to reload, and I'm going to say var question 2 is equal to new multiple choice question. The title will be income. The question is, what is your, and I've already started to type this, so I'm going to go ahead and cheat. And then for options, I'm just going to have an empty array right now. So here's my multiple choice question. And if I've done this correctly, q2.2html should inherit the 2html on the question object. And it does. So even though I haven't specified a 2HTML method here for this object, it's inheriting it because it's running the constructor on the object. So, what's different about a multiple choice question and a question? It's really this two HTML method. But I don't want to duplicate all this code. I want to reuse it. So I'm going to do this the easy way first, and then I'm going to do it a slightly better but slightly more complicated way in a second. So here's the easy way. I'm going to say this dot to final HTML is a function. And what it's going to do is set result equal to this dot to HTML. So that's the title and the question text. And then what it's going to do is loop through these options and create a radio button for each one. So for counter equals 0, counter less than options dot length, counter plus plus, I'm going to add an input box type equal, and I'm going to use double quotes in here, so I'm going to use single quotes in the outside to keep from having to backslash everything to escape everything. So the type is going to be radio. Name, that's the radio button group. And then for the name, I'm going to use the title. So that'll be income for this one. And then close off the name. And then the value, and that's going to be this option. So options subcounter is going to be the value. And then I'm going to close off the value, close off the input tag, and then add a new line. And then at the end, I'm going to return result. So that's the to final HTML method, and it uses the to HTML method that's defined on the superclass. So reload. Oh, invalid or unexpected token right here. Oh, I should have used a single quote to close that off. So single quote to close that off. All right, so that loaded. Now let's go ahead and add some options here. So 10,000 and below, and 10,000 to 50,000, and let's just do one more. So 50,000 to and above. Okay, so three options. Here's my question, multiple choice question, and then Q2 dot to final HTML. So I have this part from to HTML, and then this part for my answer. And let's go ahead and set document dot get element by ID questions equal, oh, dot enter HTML equal to that. All right, so not quite right. I need to put labels on these, and I actually want one on each line. So what I'm going to do in the survey is these are in an ordered list. So I'm going to use an ordered list here at the beginning. I'm going to add an ordered list tag. And at the end, I'm going to close that off. And there's a way of setting the alphabet for the numbering to lowercase a. And I forget what that is offhand, so let me just look that up. Ordered list. Type. So I want type equal A. Type equal, once again, we'll use A. Okay. And then each of these is going to be a list item and list item. And then before the end list item, I also want to include options sub counter plus closing off the list. All right, so let's try it now. Reload. There's my question. There's my HTML. And we'll see if it works. Good. I'm not sure I'm really a huge fan of having the letters and the radio buttons, but I'll leave it like this for now. See, this is the advantage of using a class, is that if I decide I want to change that, I only have to change it in one place. I can just change this one code and that will affect all multiple choice questions, or I can just change this code here and that will affect all questions. So I said that was the easy way, but it's not quite right. And the reason it's not quite right is because I don't really want to have a different toFinal HTML method. This is just toHTML. The only reason I'm doing this is because I can't call the toHTML method if I redefine it. So like if I do this, this is not going to work because it's going to call toHTML on this object, which is this function, which is going to call toHTML on this object, which is this function, and so on. So it won't call this. It'll call this over and over and over recursively until my stack blows up. So inside of here, I need a different name than this. And I can either do that by making this name different, or here's a little trick you can do. I'm going to create a local variable called super to HTML, and its value is this dot to HTML. So after I've run the constructor, there's a to HTML method on this object. I'm going to save that here, and then down here, I'm going to call super dot to HTML on this object. So super to html.call this. So let's go ahead and reload and we'll create our question. Oh, to final html, I want to call to html. There, and it works fine. So this is maintaining toHTML on question and then calling it as a super method inside of the toHTML in multiple choice question.